Dear students, I am Shiva, faculty of physics. I hope you are doing well in your studies with these bricks. Today, in this episode, we are going to explore one important topic for 9th standard students, that is spherical capacitor. Okay, so this topic, spherical capacitor, we are discussing as some part 1. Now, in this episode, we can discuss how can we calculate the capacitance of spherical capacitor. Remember, if you want to calculate the capacitance of any capacitor, in general we can follow some steps. So first step, give two charges, plus q minus q, for two plates of the capacitor. Later, calculation of the electric field between the plates of capacitor with the help of Gauss law. Third step, calculation of the change in the potential difference with the help of line integral by using the electric field that we have obtained with the help of Gauss law. Fourth step, just using the formula C is equal to Q by V in order to consolidate the final answer. Okay, so here we are seeing one spherical capacitor. So this spherical capacitor have two plates. One is inner sphere having the radius r1, outer sphere having the radius r2. Now say we are giving the charge. Now for this plate we are giving plus q. So for this spherical plate we are giving minus q. Okay. So what is the charge plus q here given? That plus q entirely lies where? On the outer surface of the inner sphere. What is the charge minus q we are giving now? This charge entirely lies on the inner surface of the outer sphere. Okay. Now, so the charge distribution, what we are giving, plus q minus q, we are seeing in this pattern. Now we can calculate the electric field between these two plates with the help of Gauss law. Suppose here I am using some dotted region. Okay, so this is what surface now? This is Gaussian surface. Okay, so in this Gaussian surface, we are taking one small element. Suppose I am taking this small element. For this small element, what is the direction of the electric field? This is the direction of the electric field. As well as what is the aerial vector for this small element? That aerial vector now we can see in this pattern, dA bar. Okay. Now we are applying Gauss law for this Gaussian surface. This Gaussian surface we are assuming having what radius? That is the radius smaller, okay, concentric with this inner sphere as well as the outer sphere. And as well as we are taking one element, on that element, this is the direction of the E bar, this is the direction of A bar. Now use Gauss law, then what we can get? Integral E bar dot dA bar is equal to q enclosed by epsilon naught. Okay. So here, what is this q enclosed? So the charge enclosed by this Gaussian surface we are seeing as q. That's why here what we can write again. So E bar dot dA bar. E bar direction, dA bar direction, both you are seeing as same. Na? That's why we can write E dA is equal to q by epsilon naught. Again E constant, so for this Gaussian surface what is constant? E constant. That's why again what we can write? E integral dA is equal to q by epsilon. So again E, what is the value for dA? Here dA indicates the total area of this assumed Gaussian sphere, nothing but the total area of the assumed Gaussian sphere is nothing but total surface area. That's why what we can write now, E into 4 pi r square is equal to Q by epsilon. So again here E will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by r square. So this is what number is electric field between the plates of spherical capacitor. Okay. Now in the next case we can calculate what again? We can calculate the potential difference. We can calculate the potential difference between the plates of capacitor with the help of this electric field. So what is the formula now that we have recalled here? What is the formula? Vf minus Vi is equal to minus integral I to F E bar dot ds bar. Okay, here this is what is the path of this line integral. So now this is the path of line integral. Suppose I am taking, this is the path of line integral. This is I, this is F. We are taking some small element here. This is what now? Ds. Okay. Simultaneously, this is ds. This is what? This is now radial vector, that is r bar. So this small element now we can label as, this is dr bar. Okay. So clearly we are seeing here ds is equal to minus dr. Observe, ds downward, dr bar outward, dr bar, ds bar, both are opposite to each other. That's why here we are using minus. Okay. Now what is E bar at ds bar? E bar there upward. Why? So electric field direction always we can draw how? So like this, na? This is the direction of the electric field, that is minus plus to minus. So this is the direction of electric field, this is the direction of the path of the integration. That's why here E bar dot ds bar what we can write? E bar dot ds bar now we can write Vf minus Vi, I am writing as V here, minus integral. Okay. So what is the outer surface? Outer surface lying at what radius? This is I. Outer surface lying at what radius? Outer surface here lying at r2 radius. Now this is r2. Inner surface r1. What is the value for E here? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by r square. Substitute the value of E here. Now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by r square into, so E ds, ds here minus dr. Okay. So minus minus again it will become plus. As well as here already we have one more EDS, na? This is EDS cos 180. So that's why here we can put this is plus. Why here I am writing plus? Since E bar dot ds bar is equal to EDS cos 180 degrees, that is equal to minus EDS. Okay. Now, so this take this minus sign outside as well as here Q 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught constants, na? Take that one on also outside. Now what we can write? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught integral R2 to R1. So minus also here, suppose I am taking out, it will become 1 by R square dr. Okay. So further, now you can do the integration. Then what we can write? Minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into, what is integral 1 by r square? Integral 1 by r square is minus 1 by r1. So r2 to r1. Okay, again it will become, so this minus minus again it will become plus. That's why 1 q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So this is the value for V. Okay. Now again, so observe here. So this V again we can write further. Take the LCM. What we can write now? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into r2 minus r1 divided by r1 r2. Okay, so we calculated. After the calculation of V, again what we can do? We can use the formula C is equal to Q by V in order to evaluate the C. That's why here C again we can write as Q by V. Okay, so again Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into r2 minus r1 by r1 r2. Okay, so again it will become 4 pi epsilon naught into r1 r2 divided by r2 minus r1, nothing but finally what is the value of C here we are getting? 4 pi epsilon naught into r1 r2 divided by r2 minus r1. So this is the expression for the capacitance of what type of capacitor? Parallel plate capacitor. Okay, now here suppose initially the gap between the two plates, okay, there we are seeing two plates. This is the inner plate, this is the outer plate. Initially the gap between the two plates is filled with air or vacuum. Suppose if you are filling the gap between the two plates with some dielectric, say K, at that time what we can write? So for the medium of the dielectric constant, what now? K. This above expression we can write as C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into K r1 r2 divided by r2 minus r1. Okay, so this is the capacitance for the spherical plate capacitor. When the medium between the two plates of the spherical capacitor is filled with the dielectric medium of dielectric constant K. Okay, now we can see some particular cases regarding to this formula. Suppose we are taking here case 1. What is the case 1? Suppose I am taking outer surface, that is outer sphere approximately going to infinity. Outer sphere where we are assuming lying at infinity. What is the radius of that outer sphere? Infinity. So inner sphere radius, now we are assuming here as r. Inner sphere radius how much? We are assuming as r. At that time, what is the value for the capacitance? So what is the formula now? Previously we got this formula. Now write down 4 pi epsilon naught r1 r2 divided by r2 minus r1. Suppose I am taking here r2 common. I divide numerator and denominator with r2, then what you can write? 4 pi epsilon naught into r1 divided by 1 minus r1 by r2. Now substitute the value of r2 here infinity, r1 as that, then r by infinity will become 0. So this part will become 0. So replace r1 with r. Now this expression will become C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into r. So nothing but this is the capacitance of what type of capacitor? Isolated spherical capacitor. Isolated spherical capacitor means you are seeing a spherical capacitor. In that spherical capacitor, one plate of the spherical capacitor, nothing but outer spherical plate lies at infinity. At that time we have only one spherical plate having the inner radius, and at that time its capacitance can be calculated with the help of this expression. C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into r. Okay, we can see one more case again here, case 2. Suppose we are taking R1 and R2 are large. Okay, nothing but R1 approximately, R2 approximately, both are approximately equal to R. As well as R2 minus R1 is equal to D. Okay, this D is small, so much small when compared with R1. Okay, so at that time, how this expression will modify? So R1, R2, R1 value also are, R2 value also are. Now we can write this one, R1, R2 we can write as what? C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. R1 minus R2 we are saying as D. Nothing but this one now we can write as epsilon naught into 4 pi R square. This 4 pi R square what for us? Surface area of the spherical plate capacitor. That's why now we can write this is epsilon naught A by D. Nothing but this is the formula for what? Parallel plate capacitor. So nothing but whenever you are assuming these conditions, plates of the parallel plates of the spherical plate capacitor are large and the gap between the two spherical plates is small, at that time its capacitance is approximately equal to the capacitance of what plate capacitor? Parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so now here we can see one little example in order to confirm this idea of spherical capacitor. So what is that example? So first of all, we are taking one soap bubble. Say this is soap bubble. So this is the solution of the soap bubble. So say this radius is R. Okay, the thickness of the soap bubble is T. And this soap bubble is initially charged to V. Now something happens inside the soap bubble. The soap bubble now destroyed or burst. After bursting, now this soap bubble you are seeing in the form of the drop. Okay. This drop now having some potential V prime. The question, what is the potential of this collapsed drop in terms of potential of the soap bubble, radius of the soap bubble as well as the thickness of the soap bubble. Now one thing here we need to assume. So first of all, again I am repeating the question. We have soap bubble. That soap bubble having the radius that thickness is D. That soap bubble is charged to potential V. After some time that soap bubble there burst or destroyed and it was forming part of one drop like this as shown in figure. For this drop, what is the potential V prime in terms of what? V capital T. To solve this problem, first of all concentrate how much charge that we gave for the soap bubble before bursting or before destroying. How much charge that soap bubble will contain? To calculate the charge contained by the soap bubble, here what we can do? So say what is C here? C is equal to Q by V. Q indicates the charge on the surface of the soap bubble. I am treating soap bubble contains some soap solution. Soap solution is the conductor. That's why what is the charge we gave for the soap bubble? The charge entirely lies where? On the outer surface of this bubble. That's why here Q indicates the charge on the surface of the soap bubble. Now we can write this one, Q is equal to CV. What is the value for C here? C indicates 4 pi epsilon naught into R into V. Okay, C indicates 4 pi epsilon naught into R, that is capacitance of the isolated spherical capacitor. Already we proved now here this one. Capacitance of the isolated spherical capacitor. Formula I am using here. This is 4 pi epsilon naught into R into V. Okay, one thing now clear for us. Later I want to determine the radius of this drop. how much radius of the drop here we have? Since what is the liquid solution that we have in that thickness T, that volume of the total liquid solution only here again you are seeing as the volume of the drop. That's why, what is the idea here? Total volume of the liquid solution, that is soap solution over the thickness T, is equal to total volume of the drop. Total volume of the liquid solution over the thickness T is equal to total volume of the drop. That's why here what we can write now. So this is 4 pi r square into T. This is surface area of this soap bubble. T indicates thickness of the soap bubble. Totally it will become what now? Total volume of the soap bubble is equal to total volume of the liquid, that one drop, liquid drop, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so here 4 pi cancels. Now r cube will become 3 r square into T. R will become 3 r square into T whole power 1 by 3. Okay, this is the radius of the liquid drop formed after bursting of this soap bubble. Now let us calculate the value, let us calculate the potential of this liquid drop. Now what can write? V prime is equal to charge also same, na? So here I am assuming this one containing Q charge, this one also automatically containing how much charge? Q charge. That's why here again we can write V prime is equal to Q by C prime. Okay, so what is the value for Q? Value for the Q again, this much, 4 pi epsilon naught into R into V. What is the C prime value? 4 pi epsilon naught into small r. Okay, 4 pi epsilon naught into small r. This 4 pi epsilon naught, this 4 pi epsilon naught gets cancelled. Now what we can write here? Rv divided by this R will become 3 r square T whole power 1 by 3. So this is the expression we got in terms of V prime, in terms of R T V. R T V. So this is the volume of, this is the potential of the water drop, liquid drop formed after the bursting of this soap bubble. Okay, so this is one little example in order to consolidate the concept of spherical capacitor. Okay students, today in this session what we studied here. So first of all, we took one spherical capacitor. For this spherical capacitor, inner sphere lying at radius r1, outer sphere lying at radius r2. Later we did some procedure in order to calculate what the capacitance of the spherical plate capacitor. What is the result that we got? 4 pi epsilon naught into r1 r2 divided by r2 minus r1. But remember, outside the outer sphere is 0, inside the inner sphere also is 0. So only field that we have here, that is E, not equal to 0. Okay, so after deriving this expression for the capacitance of the spherical capacitor, later we deduce the same formula again by assuming the medium between the two plates is filled with dielectric of dielectric constant K. Later we took some cases. Case 1 used in order to find out the capacitance of the isolated spherical capacitor. Case 2 here we used in order to prove capacitance of the spherical capacitor is indirectly equal to the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor when the radii of the spherical capacitor is large and the distance between the plates of the spherical capacitor is small. Next, we took one example. In this example, there what we have soap bubble, initial potential V, radius r, thickness T, thereafter it destroyed. You are seeing one small liquid drop. Again, question there, what is the potential of this liquid drop in terms of V R T? V we utilize the ideas what we discussed in these previous steps. Okay students, I hope you understood this lecture well. In the next episode, we can see the capacitance of the spherical capacitor, how can we calculate when its inner sphere earthed and outer sphere is charged, as well as outer sphere is earthed, inner sphere is charged. Thank you for watching.